Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we do unit conversions involving area, and we do the following five problems on this video. This is part three of unit conversions, and we're going to discuss area and converting one kind of area to another kind of area. So let's start off with this one. How many square feet are in one square yard? Okay, well, first of all, what does a square yard mean? What does it mean? You've got basically a square where it's 1 yard on one side and 1 yard on the other side. So we say the whole thing, the area of this is 1 square yard, which you could write as 1 yard squared. Okay, that's how we usually write it. Now, want to know how many square feet are in there? Well, if you break up a yard, there's 3 feet in a yard. So if I broke this up, that's 1 foot. There's another foot, and there's another foot, so that would be a whole yard. And I could do the same thing on the other side. 1 foot, 1 foot, and 1 foot. And if we go ahead and cross this through, inside each of here is each of these little squares is 1 square foot, because it's 1 foot times 1 foot. So this is called 1 square foot right here. Think of it as tiles. So usually when you buy carpeting, it's by the square yard, but when you buy tiles, it might be by the square foot. So if you think of this as one big square yard of carpeting, and instead you were going to put how many tiles that are 1 foot by 1 foot would fit in it, there would be 9 square feet in there. See how there's 9 of these little squares? So the answer to this is how many square feet are in 1 square yard? By looking at the picture, there's 9 square feet, and we would write that as 9 square feet. Now, notice that does not mean that the 9 is squared. It means I've got some square feet. How many of those? There's 9 of them all together. Okay, now you don't want to have to draw a picture each time, so let's move on. So we found out that 1 square yard equals 9 square feet. All right. What's another way we could have gotten that without actually drawing a picture? You could say, well, we know that one yard equals 3 feet, right? So we could square both sides because these two things are equal. And that says 1 square yard equals 9 square feet. So there's another way of getting it. Now, if you were trying to convert something from square yards to square feet, you might do it this way. You might say, well, let's say I've got 6 square yards, and I want to know how many square feet it is. So the way we were doing it before, we're going to multiply it by something that converts yards and feet, right? So we could put, well, I know there's 3 feet in 1 yard. Now, oops, sorry. The reason I'm putting the yard in the denominator is because I need to get this yard squared. But the problem is, notice this is a square yard and this only says 1 yard. So the way to rectify that is you can square everything inside this fraction. Like, remember this fraction represents the number 1, so you could just say, well, I'm squaring it, right? But when you square something, really you're squaring everything inside. So if you do that, you could just write 3 squared, feet squared, 1 squared, and yard squared. And that's how you're going to get that yard squared to cancel with that yard squared. So I cancel those yard squares, and then what does that give me? Well, in the numerator, what do I have? Be careful. It's 6 times 3 squared. So remember that 6 times 9, which is 54. And then I have the square feet, right, which is what I wanted. In the denominator, you just have 1 squared. You don't leave a 1 in the denominator. So 6 square yards is just 54 square feet. Let's try another one. So we're going to convert 8 square feet 2 square inches. Okay, so we're starting out with 8 square feet. All right, so I got to multiply it by something. So I want to see, is there a simple way to convert between inches and feet? And you know that 12 inches is 1 foot. You want your numerator to have the inches, right? And you want the denominator to have the feet, so it'll cancel. All right, so we know that, well, how does it work? 1 foot is the same as 12 inches. But here's the problem is that would only give you 1 foot. It's not going to cancel with the square feet. So we're just going to square everything here. So now what cancels? The square feet cancels. And what do I have left in the numerator? I have 8 times 12 squared. All right, I'm going to just write this out. 8 times 12 squared is 144, and you're going to have square inches. In the denominator, you just have 1, so you don't need to write it when it's just a 1 in the denominator. So just get out your calculator and do 8 times 144, and that gives you 1152. So I'm just going to rewrite this as 1152 square inches. Now, some people like writing that out in words. That's fine if you want to write square inches. That means the same thing. Okay, here's another one. How many square yards are in 1 square mile? All right. So what we're starting off with is 1 square mile. And we want to end up with square yards. So we don't have a conversion that goes directly from miles to yards, but we can go from miles to feet and then feet to yards. So I'm going to write down here at the bottom what we know. We know that 1 mile, and of course you could look this up if you forget it. 1 mile is 5280 feet. And then we know that 1 yard is 3 feet, right? Those are our conversions. So I need to first get rid of the miles. So I need to multiply by something where the miles are going to cancel. So if I put the miles in the denominator, 1 over 1 mile, and the numerator would be 5280 feet. But I have miles squared, so I got to square everything here. Okay. Now that's going to get the miles squares to cancel. So I'm okay so far. But I'm going to have my answer in square feet. But I want my answer what? In square yards. All right, so I have to do it again. Got to multiply by another fraction. And I want the feet to cancel, right? And I want to get yards, and I just have to figure out what this is going to be. Well, I know that 1 yard is 3 feet, correct? But I want to have square feet. So if I square everything in here, I've got it. Notice what this is saying is 1 square yard is 9 square feet, which is where we started off on this video. So then we've got the square feet canceling, and our answer is finally going to be just in square yards. Now, what do I have in the numerator? I've got a 1 times 5280 squared times 1 squared. That's also 1. So you're going to have to put that in your calculator, 5280 squared, divided by your denominator, which is 9. All right, so that's what you want to do in your calculator, and all you're going to have left is whatever that answer is, square yards. So try that in your calculator. And I got 3097600 square yards. It's a lot of square yards. A square mile is huge. Think about it. Okay, so 1 mile is 5280 feet, but keep in mind a square mile would be 5280 times 5280 square feet, a ton. So this is a big number, and yeah, it should be. So that's how many square mile, I'm sorry, how many square yards are in 1 square mile. Here's another one. Convert 13 square inches to square centimeters using the approximation 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters. Now, a square inch is a lot bigger than a square centimeter, so we're going to get a lot more than 13 when we figure this out. Try putting the video on pause and trying this on your own first. Okay, hopefully you tried it. So what do we start with? We're going to start with 13 square inches. And I want to multiply it by something that, if I can, that goes between inches and centimeters, which is right here. So I want the inches in the denominator. So I put 1 inch is the same thing as 2.54 centimeters. But of course, really, I want square inches to cancel. So I square everything, right? And I'm done. Now, you don't have to use this parentheses. If that confuses you, you could leave the parentheses off. I just don't write the little time sign here because I don't want you to get confused with a decimal point right there. Okay, so the square inches is going to cancel. And what is this? What am I left with? Well, I'm going to have just one in the denominator, so it's just going to be a whole number. So I have 13 times 2.54 squared. So you're going to have to square this number times 13, and your answer is going to be in square centimeters. So go ahead, get out your calculator and try that. All right, I get 83.8708 square centimeters. 83. Okay, and it should be a lot more because remember there's 2.5 centimeters an inch. So just look at the picture again. If here's a square inch, right, the centimeter is like 2.5 of those. It's like, 2 plus is like a half, right? So if you kind of look at a picture, these aren't exactly whole centimeters, but this is 4 plus all this extra space here. So there's a lot of square centimeters. There's like about 6 if you added this all up. It's close to that, a little bit bigger. There's 6 square centimeters actually in a square inch. This is just 1 inch. Okay, let's do one more. How many square kilometers are in a square mile? So it means I start with a square mile and my answer's got to be in square kilometers. Now, a kilometer is smaller than a mile, so there's going to be more square miles than in a square. I'm sorry. There are going to be more square kilometers than there are in a square mile. All right, so we're going to start with 1 square mile. Okay. All right. Now, we're going from English to metric. So we've got miles in the first thing we need to do is change that to feet because we know, remember, that 1 mile is 5280 feet. But of course, I have square miles, so I have to square everything. Now, of course, you don't have to put 1 squared because we know 1 squared is the same as 1, but I'm just being consistent here. And our square miles will cancel out. All right. So I'm trying to get to kilometers, right? So I'm still not to the metric, but I know this conversion between inches and centimeters. So first let's get this to inches. So all right, let's do this because we've got square feet now. We know there's 1 foot in 12 inches. And of course, we're going to square it because we want to get rid of the square feet. And now the square feet are going to cancel. Okay, so I got my square inches. Okay. But now I've got to move over to my metric, and let's use the 2.54 approximation we've been using. So we know that 1 inch is approximately 2.54 centimeters, and I'm going to square everything, right? And I'm running out of room here, but so I'm going to just have to go time. I'll try to make this a little bit smaller. We're almost there. We just need to get the centimeters to kilometers. So you do have to know your metric system. And so what we want to do is get the centimeters to cancel out. So the question is, in 1 kilometer, how many centimeters are there? Well, there's 1,000 meters, but that many centimeters in a kilometer. So again, we got to square everything, and that will cancel out that and that. And now I'm going to look at all the numerators and all the denominators, and what do we have here? We've got 5280 squared times 12 squared times 2.54 squared, right? That's going to be my numerator. Kilometers squared, which is what I'm looking for, and in the denominator, I'm going to divide by this huge number, which is, what is that, 100,000 squared. It can be pretty big. So you got to put all that in your calculator. So go ahead and put that in your calculator now. This is pretty tricky to enter in your calculator, so I'm showing you what I did. 5280 squared is this big number here, and then 12 squared is 144. 2.54 squared is 6.4516, and in the denominator, this number, 100,000 times 100, let's see, did I put 10,000 instead of 100,000? Yes, I did. I meant to put 100,000. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just deal with dividing by this 100,000. Basically, that means move the decimal. If I'm dividing by this, I'm going to move this one up here, 5 to the left. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now I'm going to just take that number. That's divided that out. And then if I want to take the, move this one over for two of these zeros, I'm going to move the decimal. I'm going to move this decimal over three places for three of the zeros. So actually, it goes three more places. And then for these two zeros, I'm going to move this one in two places. So I've done my division. So now in my calculator, I'm going to put in this number, 0.278784 times 1.44 times 6.4516, and that was kilometers squared. Remember, I canceled the inches squared too, and let's see what we get. Okay, what I get, this is approximately 2 point, and I'm going to round to the nearest tenth, 2.6 square kilometers. Very tricky problem. Man, if you could do that, you've got it down.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.